The 12-week trial came to a dramatic end earlier this afternoon. As you know, a lot of people have been watching this trial, waiting for the outcome, not just here, but all across the country. Tonight, the bottom line is one church official is in jail. The other is a free man. The jury of seven men and five women found Monsignor William Lynn guilty on one count of endangering the welfare of a child. The historic decision makes Lynn the first U.S. church official convicted in connection with the clergy child abuse scandal. The 61-year-old was immediately taken into custody after the judge revoked his bail.
Anything you want to say?
His family left the courtroom in tears.
He's upset. He's crushed. He's in custody, and he didn't want anything other than to help kids. He's crushed about this.
Lynn, accused of shuffling suspected predator priests from parish to parish while secretary for clergy in the Philadelphia Archdiocese, was acquitted of a second charge of endangerment and a charge of conspiracy. He's facing up to 7 years in prison for the one count.
Depending on what the sentence is, we're very likely to file an appeal.
And while Lynn sits in jail tonight, his co-defendant, Father James Brennan, is a free man. He was accused of sexually abusing a 14-year-old boy back in 1996, but the jury could not agree on a verdict.
My faith is what got me through all this. My faith and, you know, the prayers from family, from friends that have just been constant, constant.
NBC 10 spoke with several jurors. They said deliberations were tough.
There were some tears in the room. We were angry. There was frustration.
As for what the contributing factors that made them a hung jury in Brennan's case.
I think the witnesses that we did have, we either didn't find them very credible or they just didn't give us enough.
Well, some of us felt like that we may have wanted to have heard from Brennan. So that was one of the things that kind of had some of us hung up.